TC, you be doing too much, bro.
So I had a couple thoughts about this Collider situation. And if you guys aren't aware, Collider has decided to fire a bunch of personalities that were currently doing their shows. And they're no longer going to be doing the shows that pretty much built that freaking platform. Jedi Counsil, Heroes, and Movie Talk. And they're going to go in a direction where it's like they want to go for the videos that are going to bring in the views, right? And you can't knock them on that, but actually you can knock them on that, and I'm going to talk about it later. But they're going to start gearing towards like deep fakes and celebrity type content, which YouTube loves celebrity type content. Not, have you checked the YouTube Rewind? It's one of the most disliked videos because YouTube itself is becoming more corporate and people hate that because YouTube is YouTube, the average nobody. I'm a nobody. It's for us to thrive and to become somebody, right? People don't go to YouTube to watch celebrity content. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting off topic, but I feel like I'm informed enough to speak about this because I've been watching Collider a very long time, and I'm not even going to front. I dropped off when a lot of people dropped off and their views started to decline. I started back in 2011 and watching AMC Movie Talk with John Campea, John Schnepp, and Amy Rose. That's when I started. And say what you want about John Campea. I'm not the biggest fan of his. I disagree with his DCEU opinion, especially BVS and Man of Steel. But you got to respect the guy and what he built, because back in 2011, a Movie Talk, almost professionally looking show like that on YouTube was a big freaking deal. And it built a community around it. I feel for him because it was his creation, right? And at the time, Collider was nothing. Collider was a YouTube channel posting trailers and clips of trailers, and that's how they would get their views. It was basically nothing. It was an entertainment website. It was a blog. And the owner at Collider, or I don't know how it happened, but they reached out to John Campea. Hey John, can you do what you did with AMC Movie Talk, and we'll merge together, do it for Collider. And he did. And he did it well, because John has a good eye for talent, okay? And so he built these shows, Collider Movie Talk, Jedi Heroes. He hired the right people and he put them in the right places to succeed. And like I said, I have nothing but respect for John because he built everything. And to watch what they did with what he built and to watch it like take a nosedive, that's got to be hard for him. That's got to be hard for him. But I'm making this video because I think that Collider is going to eventually die, or especially the community aspect. And I have three big reasons why it's gonna die. So here we go. Reason number one, you lost the personalities that built it. Now, when I think of Collider and AMC Movie Talk and the A-Team, it's John Campea himself, John Schnepp, Christian Harloff, and Mark Ellis, the schmoes, okay? And you can argue till the cows come home, and I've watched John's video saying that the talent wasn't the problem, but I disagree because, Christian Harloff and Mark Ellis and Schnepp were able to maintain a really good base there on Collider. RIP to John Schnepp, man. But after, he passed and after Christian left and Mark left, you had the B squad in there. You had the practice squad in there trying to carry everything afloat. Now, no offense to them, because that's not the sole reason why people stopped watching, but it is a big reason, because those shows, Collider Movie Talk, Heroes, Jedi Counsil, that was built on Christian Harloff and Mark Ellis's camaraderie and their back and forth together. You can't teach that with somebody else. You can bring somebody else in and try and replicate that, but that is just a bond that's hard to replicate. John Schnepp and Heroes John Campea's bond with John Schnepp, people felt that through the screen, okay? And so when those four pillars left, the views started to decline because the whole thing was built on those A personalities. Okay, so besides being, you know, the B squad in there, I also feel that Collider tried to do a lot of different things in terms of putting out a bunch of different content, and that hurts a YouTube channel algorithmically. Like, if you're having the same type of content, say you put out Collider Heroes, Collider Movie Talk, Jedi Counsil, right? It's all similar. But when you start going into some sports and you throw into some celebrity interviews, and it's like, whoa, the algorithm is like, you're messing me up. You're not feeding me what I need. And I felt like that also led to a decline in views. But that's on the YouTube end of things. But anyway, yeah. So, I mean, say what you want, but those four personalities no longer being at Collider, that is a huge reason why it started to decline. Schnepp, Campea, Harloff, and Ellis. So reason number two, milquetoast opinions and 2PC. There was a time where I enjoyed watching Collider Movie Talk because I was like, okay, like we're going to get to see, you know, these guys' personalities and go back and forth. And it wasn't super, super tight-lipped and super, super political. And also, it wasn't like people couldn't be themselves on it. But you started to see a change once Collider took over. It seemed to me that people were being less genuine to be themselves. And I mean, there could be a bunch of different reasons for this. It could be company policy. You're not supposed to speak on something like that. But back in the day, watching AMC Movie Talk and the early version of Collider, you had a young TC, right? I was there. I was sitting here. I was like, man, it would be really cool to build myself up, right? To make myself somebody in this community to where I will eventually be able to get the chance to maybe appear on a Collider Movie Talk. It was cool back then. It was like, man, you know, you really wanted to work your way up to be invited to a show and something like that. But along the way, especially more recently, I realized I would never make it there. I would never be able to be myself there. And I don't think they would want me there because I have no filter. And I felt like a lot of the more recent content, people were just scared. People were just scared to say what they want and what they felt, basically because of a lot of backlash that they would get. Also, they work for a company and I don't blame them. Okay, people will say they're shills, right? They shill because they get free access or early access to movies and stuff like that. And yes, it's true. Okay, I know Campea likes to say, oh, you know, let me just show you my fat paycheck by Disney. Of course, they didn't give you a freaking paycheck, John, but you do get access to early content. You get to go to these screenings in LA. You get invites to exclusive movies. And guess what these invites do for you guys? They allow you to see the movie early. They allow you to make your YouTube video early. And they allow you to put out your content earlier than anybody else. And if you know YouTube, being early and having good content for it to rank as soon as you're able to post that, the embargo lifts, boom, that rockets you up. So yes, it does come with perks. And, you know, if you're at the level where, you know, you're like, oh, I can get invited to somewhere and I'll still give my honest opinion. Like, you could do that if you're at a certain level. But I felt like a lot of people on Collider, they were just too scared to say what they really felt, or they started to find people who didn't have interesting opinions at all. And all of the people that, you know, were on those shows liked everything. They liked everything. It didn't matter if the movie was complete garbage. They just loved everything. They consumed. And they had really, you know, no controversial opinions at all. And that makes for a boring show. So that is reason number two. Let's go ahead and get into what I think is the biggest reason. All right, so the biggest reason why Collider will fail in terms of community is because Collider chose views and celebrities over the community. Now, let me explain what I mean. A couple years ago, it was San Diego Comic-Con, I forget what year, but there was a Collider meetup, right? And, you know, in that Collider meetup, and I actually went to that one, you got to meet a bunch of people that worked on Collider, right? They tarped off a certain section. You got to go in and hang out with John Campea, hang out with John Schnepp, hang out with Harloff and stuff like that. That's called community, okay? That's something that you have to build. Now, the direction that Collider wants to go, screw the personalities, right? They're going to have... You think someone's going to want to go to a Collider meetup and hang out with the deep fake guy who does George Lucas? No. The reason we wanted to go to a Collider meetup is because we wanted to talk to Christian or John, or we wanted to talk to Schnepp. And I actually went and I talked to Schnepp, and I was talking about, you know, the movie that he came out with, The Death of Superman Lives, and how awesome it was. I knew about Schnepp, and I knew what he liked and disliked based on the movie conversations, the dumb fart jokes. I knew his personality. I knew how he interacted with other co-hosts. I knew a lot about him because we got to grow with him, okay? That's why people want to go to meetups, because you feel... By watching this type of content every day, you feel like you get to know the person, right? I could go up to John Campion and say, yeah, I didn't like Man of Steel or BVS at all, and I totally disagree with you. And you knew it would rile him up because he totally loved, I forget which one he loved, but he loved one of those two or both of them. But, I mean, in the future, are you guys going to have any Collider hangouts like that, Collider meetups? Who are we going to go meet? Who are we going to go meet now? Are we going to go talk, like I said, to the George Lucas deep fake guy and be like, hey, let me get a selfie, right? You get a selfie. Oh, hey, cool, guys. Look, I'm taking a picture with the deep fake guy. And then, boom, on their way. Now, you judge that against going to meet someone who you think is your friend when they're really not your friends. You're kind of just watching them, right? But it's a big difference in community. And that is going to be the downfall. Now, they might rocket in views, guys. Like these deep fakes that they make, these highly produced deep fakes, they might get, I don't know, 1 million views per video. And the celebrity type content, they might get 1 million views for their, you know, interviewing The Rock, Dwayne Johnson, or Will Smith. But that's not going to build community. That's not going to sustain you. That's trendy. The deep fakes are trendy. But what happens when that trend dies, or when other people learn how to do these deepfakes better than you or at your level? You have to find another trend and hop on it. And it makes business sense for you, I guess, in terms of monetary value. Because I understand it did get hard to keep these shows alive in terms of money and the amount of views they were bringing in. But I have a suggestion for that later on to you, Mark Fernandez, who is the owner of Collider. Or the new boss that came in and kind of just fired everybody who worked on those shows, basically. But anyway, yeah. So when Collider decided to put views and celebrity and money over the community, I feel like that is going to be a big reason why Collider fails moving forward in terms of community. Because like I said, I'm hedging my bet here. They might do fantastic in terms of views, but... Is that really the brand that they want to go forward as? Just another, you know, just another The Independent or The Hollywood Reporter going to press junkets. Hey, Tom Holland, how did you like to be in the new Spider-Man? Like, is that what you guys want to do for the rest of 2020 and beyond? Or do you guys want to lift up your own people? Because... You took Christian Harloff, Mark Ellis, Schnepp, Campea. You turned them into quasi-celebrity. You built your own people. And that's what I feel YouTube is all about. That's why when people, when celebrities come onto YouTube, people are like, I mean, they're already famous. Yeah, they're not really that interested because they just bring all their clout from being a celebrity. And it's just different. It's different than the average Joe in their room making a video. Okay. But But anyway, if I had some last bit of advice for Mark Fernandez, I know he's not watching, but if he happens to stumble upon this video, I would say that you should bring back the movie type discussion shows, but this is what you got to do, all right? You have to hire a very talented talent scout. Hire John Campea just to be your freaking talent manager or whatever, your talent scout, to scour YouTube. There are a lot of entertaining and talented people on YouTube right now that you could pluck from and be like, man, this guy or this girl would be fantastic for a show, right? And you could pump up those numbers, okay? I mean, you kind of just, you fired everybody that you had. You did a clean sweep, okay? But in order to kind of get back the community, I would look into, you know, scouring YouTube, scouring talent, finding the personalities you want to move forward with at Collider, and giving it another shot. So that is my last bit of advice. I want to know what you guys think about this whole Collider situation. Let me know what you guys think in terms of, you know, did you ever start watching Collider or AMC Movie Talk? Did you stop watching? Why did you guys stop watching? And things like that. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this little video. If you guys did, subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, share it, all that jazz. And I'll see you guys later. Peace out, guys.